So I was just browsing through my YouTube videos and I realized that I haven't done a video on my GoPro for quite some time now. So let's do one today. And let's talk about how to edit your footage in order to make it look cinematic. So as a first step, let's have a quick look at my GoPro settings and how I shoot video. And then as a second step, let's have a look at how I color grade the footage in order to make it look cinematic. To really bring out that cinematic feel, let's do this in slow motion. And for that, we have to change the resolution to 1080p in order to get access to higher frame rates. And then let's change the frame rate to 120 frames per second in order to have enough frames to slow the footage down considerably, but still have it look smooth. When shooting in high frame rates, you can either choose wide or narrow for your field of view. In order to make the movie look cinematic, if you can, choose narrow to avoid that fisheye effect. Otherwise, let's go with wide and I show you how to get rid of the distortion in post. These are my standard video settings that are barely changed. The color profile is set to flat, the white balance to native, the ISO to 800, and the sharpness to low. The rest I leave at standard. Unfortunately, we can't use image stabilization with frame rates higher than 60 frames per second, and auto low light, I just keep that on. So here you have it, guys. These are my video settings for the GoPro. This is how I shoot video. Now let's jump over to Final Cut Pro and let's have a look at how I color grade the footage. Unfortunately, I don't have footage resembling a feature film, but a more demanding, busy street scene that we have to work with today. Even though I shot this scene on a gimbal, let's make the footage even more smooth and turn on image stabilization. And as a next step, we slow the footage down under the retiming options. Under the fast and slow submenus, you can choose some predefined options, but we click on custom to specify how slow the footage should be. Since we are editing on a 24 frames per second timeline and having shot in 120 frames per second, we can slow the footage down 5 times, which is 20% of the original speed. 20% times 5 is 100%, 24 frames per second times 5, 20 times 5 is 120 frames per second, which we use to shoot the video. As we can see, the video already looks very good, but it is a bit jittery, which we can fix easily by again clicking on the retiming options. Let's go to video quality and then let's choose optical flow. Optical flow creates new frames between the actual frames of your footage. So instead of repeating them or blending them together, we create new ones and therefore the playback is more smooth. Next, we are getting rid of the fisheye effect, and as you can see here on the side of the screen, the bar, there's quite a bit of distortion that we need to fix. Let's jump into the effect panel, and here you can find an effect called fisheye, and we'll just drag and drop this on our footage. Don't get discouraged by the crazy effect it adds, because once we lower the amount down below zero, it takes away any bulging fisheye effect rather than adding it to your footage. Shooting in wide with my GoPro, I usually add -2 to -4, but this is something that you need to try and get the results that you like the most. You can also fine-tune or tweak the effect by adjusting the virtual center of the frame, which gives you a slightly different result. Okay, -4 I believe looks better, and then we'll need to adjust the center. I'll probably bring it back to zero again. So now that we pulled the footage towards the center of the frame, we have these black bars, left and right, top and bottom. In order to get rid of them, we just need to crop in a little. 110% did the trick, and let's have a quick look at our footage, but I believe it looks good now. And with that, I think we are now ready to go to color grade the footage. Now, color grading is an art on its own, and I'm really not an expert, but we could speak here for hours about how to color grade the footage. I'm just covering the very basics to give you a jumpstart as to how to approach this matter. If you want more info, just let me know in the comments down below and I will make a more detailed tutorial. Now let's make ourselves a little space here and then let's jump into the effects panel and choose color correction. And let's just drag and drop it onto our footage. So now if you click on color board under color correction 1, which just appeared, you can see that you have three areas to adjust: the exposure, the saturation, and the color of our footage. Before we make any adjustments though, let's turn on video scopes, which will give us a visual representation of what it is that we are doing to the footage. The waveform monitor here shows the relative levels of the brightness and color levels of our current clip, as you can see here with the overlay. The highlights sit at the top, the mid-tones around 50 in the middle, and the shadows at the bottom, with 0 being black. You can also look at and adjust the RGB levels separately. And remember that equal amounts of red, green and blue result in neutral colors, with full-on red, green and blue being white and none of them being black. Everything in the middle are gray tones. So now under exposure, when we are pulling the shadows down, we can see how we add more contrast, but we also know that we can't go below 0 because otherwise we would be crashing the blacks. And with the highlights, sometimes you can recover some information by pulling them down, but as you can see, it's flat at the top, so we leave them where they are. So now that we fixed the exposure and the contrast of our footage, let's have a look at the RGB levels. And for that, we want to find a spot in our footage with a lot of neutral colors, like white, black, or gray, which helps us to set the levels easier, because as I said earlier, the equal amount of red, green, and blue will result in neutral colors. And here on the right hand side, we have a black, a white, and again a black t-shirt, which will give us visual clues in the waveforms as to how and where we need to adjust the levels. And here we can already see that we have slightly more red in the image than green and blue, and we always start making adjustments with the mid-tones, because these have the biggest impact. So I found the woman on the motorbike in the waveforms, and I make the adjustments based on her black t-shirt, and this looks already very good. But when I look at the black t-shirt of the woman in the very right, there are still some adjustments to be done in the shadows. So this looks already good. Next we look at saturation, and here you could increase saturation separately for the highlights, midtones, and shadows. But overall I'll just increase the saturation to 50%. So this is it. This is our base color grade. Now in order to give it a filmic look, you could theoretically add another instance of color correction on your footage and start tweaking the colors, but I think this is very complicated, especially for beginners, and you won't get the results you're after. So I recommend working with LUTs. LUT stands for lookup table, and it changes the colors of your footage to corresponding colors based on that lookup table. It's almost like a filter that you put on your footage in order to give it a specific look. I bought a pack of 60 filmic lookup tables from Pixel Film Studios. There are a lot of free ones out there as well, but this one comes with a very functional LUT loader too, which Final Cut Pro in itself doesn't provide. So overall, $30, I found it's a pretty good deal. So you just click on the LUT drop-down menu in order to pick the LUT you like. And you can go, for instance, with the Fuji look, or you can pick the Kodak filmic look. And what I really like about this LUT loader is that you can use it with external LUTs as well. So if you download some additional ones, then you can use this LUT loader in order to apply it to your footage. Most LUT loaders allow you to specify or adjust how much of the lookup table you want to apply to your footage. The best results usually you get with 50 to 60%. I just leave it at 100% for now. So now let's start making some final tweaks to the footage. And on the left-hand side, we can see that it's rather dark, so we want to lift the shadows. And we do this by adjusting the gamma value. But before we mess things up, let's bring up the video scopes again and let's have a look at the waveforms to make sure that we are not crushing the blacks or blowing out the highlights. Now let's lift the shadows in order to bring back some of the information in the darker areas of our footage, and then let's bring down the highlights slightly as well in order to recover some of the information in the highlights. So this looks already very good, and I believe we're almost done, but before we wrap things up, let's add a bit of sharpening. And you can either use Final Cut's own sharpening effect, or what you can do is what I do here and use Pro Edge, which is another effect from Pixel Film Studios. And the advantage here is that you not only increase details of your image, but you can also add a nice dynamic range effect. And if you're shooting an interview, for example, you can add some skin smoother as well. So let's have a look at where we are, and I believe it already looks very good. But in order to give our footage or our video the final touch, let's add the letterbox effect in order to really drive that cinematic look home. Let's find letterbox in the effects panel, and then let's just drag and drop it onto our footage. And then under its options, you can choose the aspect ratio. I usually go with 2:35:1. And then if you want, you can adjust the offset as well. And that's it. So let's have a look what we created together. So this is it, guys. This is how I shoot video with my GoPro and color grade it in Final Cut Pro to make the footage look cinematic. And I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or feedback, as always, just leave a comment down below. And with that, I catch you guys in my next video.